Also at the Capitol, there is a battle simmering over public safety. And plans for your dream home are right in the middle of this. It's all about requiring sprinklers inside new homes. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Jay Coles explains how this could cost new home buyers thousands of dollars when they build.
When a fire like this one ignites a home, firefighters want something on the inside that helps knock down flames before they arrive.
There's nothing that works better. Birth control doesn't work as good as sprinklers.
Fire chiefs across the state want Minnesota to require all new homes to have sprinklers.
Everything's sprinkled. Apartments are sprinkled. Condos are sprinkled. The last thing left? Single-family, one- and two-family homes.
Fire officials say studies show sprinklers in buildings do help save lives.
Not just the individual's lives, but those responders also, police, fire, and EMS that are going to those calls.
But those whose livelihoods depend on new home construction say the cost is not fair to them or the new home buyer.
We think there's some pent-up demand. We see people wanting to get back into new housing again, and every time we raise the bar financially, it just makes it that much harder.
Home builders say it could add as much as $15,000 to the cost of a home.
Because if you're on city sewer and water, that's one thing. If you're on a well and septic, that's quite another. And so there's a wide range of potential price variation.
Fire officials say it's much less.
We can show you thousands of invoices where those townhouses and those single families are $3,000 to $4,000.
And home builders say the housing market should determine the need, not government.
The fact of the matter is the customer writes out the check.
Now, new homes like this one right here in Woodbury would not be affected by any fire code change. It would be grandfathered in. It would just be any new home built down the road. Leah?
Well, Jay, this is an issue that we've seen come up in the past. Tell us, what's different this time around, and really, is there anything home builders can do about it at this point?
You know, it's still pretty much the same debate. This change comes about, it's administrative, not legislative, so the Department of Industry and Labor changes the fire codes. Right now, they're proposing to change it to mandate the sprinklers. Now, the Home Builders Association, they've gotten behind a bill at the Capitol. They're trying to attach it to a bill as an amendment, actually, that would prohibit this mandate. But if the home builders are not successful, you can expect to see this change sometime in the next 6 months, certainly before the end of the year. And in the end, it would cost homeowners more when they build a new home. Leah?
All right. We'll see what happens at the Capitol. Jay, thanks.